In a typical project, you have some few walls of different type, different thickness, and possibly individual layer structure inside your walls. The most effective way is to specify your wall properties before you insert walls in your project. In our example, we start with an exterior wall. Set the start point of your first wall with a left mouse click. Open the wall property dialog from the right mouse button context menu. By default, our walls consist of a single layer. On the layer structure property page, you can add more layers above or outside the existing. Click on new layer above. In our 2D sketch control, you see that a new layer has been added, using the same properties for now. Click on the layer in our sketch and edit name and thickness of the new layer, in our example called air. The 2D representation of wall layers is defined by the material. You can select one of our predefined materials or just click directly on the material button. The building material dialog opens, and on the 2D display page you find all necessary options to specify how your wall should look like in your floor plans and sections. When your wall layer structure has been completed, you can click on the Save as Default button on the right side of the software. That saves your current settings for further planning sessions, separately for each wall type. You can also save the wall layout as a layout file in order to load the layout anytime later for other wall types, or in other projects. In our example, we have defined the layout of the wall and continue to draw the contour of our building. At this stage, there is no room and the software cannot decide which wall side belongs to such a room and which one is an exterior wall side. The 2D representation at this time depends on how you draw your walls, clockwise or counterclockwise. This might be a bit surprising, but when you close the building contour with your last wall, the software automatically recognizes room sides and the exterior and rotates the walls. As already mentioned, you can load a previously saved wall layout from the layer structure dialog and assign it to a wall. Keep in mind that the layer structure also defines the wall thickness, and if the thickness changes, you have to define how. Standard behavior is that changing the thickness applies to the wall axis, means the wall becomes thicker or thinner on both sides. In many cases, this is not correct because it would also change the overall dimensions of your building, for example. When a wall changes its thickness, you can choose to which side the modification is relating to from the list in our dialog,